on for my city.
So this is where we work out at school. This is where class works out. The girls usually work out in here with the guys on the weightlifting team.
Together?
Yeah. And
okay.
All the non-weightlifters, track and field athletes work out outside the parking lot. Pretty simple. Everybody's responsible for their own weights. They grab a bar. And then there's enough weights in here. Everybody gets 5 kilo high-tech plates. A 10 kilo bumper on each side. And then once everybody does that, it takes about 4 minutes to set up 20 platforms. And everything looks the same. So in the back, you get your bar, you get your high-tech plates, you get your 10 kilo bumpers. And then out front, everybody gets a squat rack and a bar and some bumpers and then whatever's left in there. It takes about 6 minutes. And then we go through our snatch progression, our clean progression. This is D'Angelo Osorio. He's still a junior. He was on the junior world team last year. He was a student here. He was second in the 94 kilo class at the American Open. He won juniors last year and he's gonna be on the junior world team this year. The football guys, when we first got here with David's group, a lot of it was attributed to weightlifting because nobody had ever lifted weights and played football here before me and Phil Frino got here. Mm-hmm. And then the second wave we just won this year, we had a lot of kids buy back. We went 0-11 like 2 years ago because we got rid of all the kids who didn't work out.
Right.
We like went 0-11, then we made the playoffs the next year, and then this year we won the championship, went 11-1.
All right.
And everybody
what a turnaround.
Everybody was cleaning, everybody was snatching, everybody on defense cleaned 100 kilos or more. Whether you're on the track team, whether you're on the football team, whether you're a weightlifter, you're on a 3-day-a-week program. Mm-hmm. Kids come up to 5 or 6 days, so they'll repeat the program.
Mm-hmm. I think a lot of people don't know how to implement this, make it a practical day-to-day experience. And so you've shown how you can do that very easily, and you see have results from it already. I mean, it took time to get those results, but it's happening.
I think the value of the high-tech plates, number one, they don't break. Number two, they look like regular weights, so kids don't feel like self-conscious about lifting lighter weights. And if they can lift the lighter weights the right way, the big weights will come.
Mm-hmm.
You know, David Garcia, who's snatching 150, he started with a 20 kilo bar.
Mm-hmm.
So if we have 10 sets of high-tech plates, so those 10 sets go on all 10 training platforms outside for summer camp, and everybody starts the same way. They start with a 10 kilo bar, a 15 kilo bar, or a 20 kilo bar, and they progress to, you know, the 2.5s, then the 5s, then the 5s and the 2.5s, and then they go to the 10 kilo bumper. So they take gradual increases. And it's just the easiest way to make sure kids can drop the weight, mm-hmm. being safe, and mm-hmm. kids don't put too much weight on right away. But yeah, it's great. I mean, we're really, really lucky. We're really, really lucky. You know, so if you're at a high school, use some high-tech plates, college, anything. Anything where you're outside or inside and you need to teach the progression from the bottom up, you should have the high-tech plate.
Okay. Thank you, Bob. No I just problem. Wanted to hear people to hear from you and see it.
Yeah, and I'm at the ground level. I'm at the high school. I got middle school kids, elementary school kids, and high school kids. I put on